Every autumn, more than a million high school football players rumble onto fields across the nation, ready to muscle and claw their way into the end zone. But in the pursuit of victory, risk abounds. Joseph Redmond played in dozens of football games for Marin Catholic High School, but there was one game during his sophomore year he will never forget.
The opposite player was running full speed at me. I was running full speed at him, and when we collided, we went head-to-head, and we both hit the ground pretty hard. I remember opening my eyes and seeing this green fluorescent light. It really scared me. I took my helmet off. I didn't know where I was. I didn't know why I was even at a football game.
Joe was rushed to the emergency room, where he was diagnosed with a concussion. A brain injury experienced by millions of people each year in the U.S., especially while playing contact sports.
What happens in a concussion is you have some sort of traumatic blow to the head or a rapid acceleration, deceleration of the head. And the brain hits these bony structures inside of the skull, and that causes damage to occur. And this damage can cause symptoms such as a loss of consciousness, loss of memory, headache, nausea, dizziness, blurred vision.
In 2015, a new California law took effect to help cut the risk of concussions for middle and high school football players by limiting full contact practice to twice per week. A student who sustained a concussion must also wait at least a week before returning to play. But it's not just male athletes who are at risk for concussions. Female athletes playing contact sports are also vulnerable to these head injuries. Gabriela Fernandez, a classmate of Joe's, suffered a concussion during volleyball practice.
I was going for one of the balls and I kind of like slipped and hit my head forward on the ground. And I felt like kind of dizzy, but I didn't think it was anything to worry about at first. I went back to practice, I think a week later, and then the symptoms started getting worse, and I couldn't really concentrate. The headaches were probably the worst part, and I noticed myself getting a lot slower. I didn't really know too much about concussions. I thought to get a concussion, you'd have to be like completely knocked out.
The test you're about to take is actually the exact same test that every single NFL player has to take.
Eric Freitag is a neuropsychologist in Walnut Creek, California, who helps dozens of athletes get back on track each year after suffering concussions.
My role in the treatment of an athlete is to objectively measure through testing how their brain is functioning in order to determine the severity of a concussion and also to monitor recovery. One of the tests that I give is called the impact test, and the athletes will take it before their sports season begins. Should that athlete have a concussion injury, we can then use their baseline test and have them take the same test after their injury that allows us to make an apples to apples comparison.
The test is a tough mental workout.
What the impact test measures is common areas of brain function that are affected after a concussion, like memory. Not only verbal memory, but visual memory. It also measures reaction time and processing speed.
Joe first took the test before the start of football season. He then took it again after his helmet-to-helmet hit.
So here we have your baseline right here, right?
Mm-hmm.
Perfect, it looks just fine. Shows your verbal memory and verbal processing, 94th percentile. That's very, very high average. And then boom, the concussion happens. You take the test 3 days later, and look what happens to your verbal memory. That's less than first percentile.
So wow.
Severely impaired. If we didn't have this test, we would not have known that your brain was still injured.
A concussion, by definition, is a mild traumatic brain injury. Although there is no cure for it, symptoms resolve in a week to 10 days for most people. But for some, recovery can take months or longer.
If I were to play another year, I could just, I don't know, I could, lost it.
Concussions can happen at any age, but kids are particularly vulnerable to their harmful effects because their brains are still developing.
There's a subset of these individuals, at least 15%, that go on to have persistent problems. These aren't simply just having your bell rung. These are life-changing events.
The symptom that has stayed with me is trying to find words in sentences.
Traumatic brain injury and concussions in general are a major public health issue in this country. There are at least 2.5 million documented head injuries every year, and we estimate in upwards of 4 to 5 million concussions every year.
Dr. Geoffrey Manley is the chief of neurosurgery at San Francisco General Hospital, where he and his team treat more than 1,000 traumatic brain injuries each year. But even a mild traumatic brain injury, such as a concussion, is a challenge to treat given the complexity of the human brain.
Brain injury is one of the most complicated injuries in the most complicated organ in the body. The brain is an organ of functional connectivity, and for it to work right, all the parts have to work together. Think about the brain like an electronic machine. If you start removing some of the wires, it may not work so well. And so if we have an injury to the wiring of the brain, say for example between the memory and the learning portions, it's really not a far stretch to understand if those areas are disconnected that they're no longer going to function in the same way again.
In 2010, Dr. Manley led a team of researchers to track 600 concussion patients for 6 months after their injuries. The study showed the value of using magnetic resonance imaging to detect damage to the wiring of the brain.
For traumatic brain injury today, CT scanning is still the gold standard. But when we use an MRI scan, we begin to see abnormalities that we cannot see on a CT scan. We begin to see microbleeds, and when you have many of these microbleeds, your processing speed slows down.
In fact, MRI scans revealed brain microbleeds and bruising in 27% of the patients who otherwise had normal CT scans.
And what's interesting and important about this finding is these patients with these abnormalities on their MRI scan really took much longer to recover and did worse by 3 months. They had difficulty concentrating, they had difficulty returning to work.
In 2013, Dr. Manley got funding to expand the study by recruiting 3,000 traumatic brain injury patients across the U.S.
Just like with heart disease and cancer, we need new imaging tools. We need blood tests to help to guide us. We need to understand what the genetics are. And then this way we can develop a more personalized approach to the treatment because there's no one size fits all for something as complicated as a brain injury. Dopamine, one of the major neurotransmitters, is very important for brain function. Recently, we have identified a variant in a gene in the dopamine pathway, and what we found is that patients with this variant do much worse from traumatic brain injury than those that don't have this variant. We're looking at a blood test that tells us whether you have or have not had a traumatic brain injury. That will really facilitate more rapid care and really get patients to the right person at the right time.
Until then, the impact of one concussion may be enough for athletes like Joe to avoid the risk of another brain injury.
No one told me that I didn't have to play football. I just ultimately thought that it just wasn't worth it to go through another one of those concussions again.
As we move forward with traumatic brain injury and concussion, I hope to really better define this so that we can tell patients, yes, you can return to play, or no, it would really be better if you didn't return to play because we've observed other people like you that didn't do so well. I'm very hopeful and excited for the future. I believe that with this precision medicine approach, we can have the same kind of success that we've had in heart disease and cancer with traumatic brain injury.